Hello traders, my name is Karim. I'm a community ambassador for HaasOnline. In this video, I'll show how to convert a script from Pine to HaasScript. The languages have very similar syntax. Both are pretty simple and HaasScript is a bit more intuitive. So if you know PineScript, converting it to HaasScript should not be a problem. The conversion has several steps, which don't have to be in a specific order, but I'll show you how I prefer to do it. We will need to fix comments, indexing, variable types, an operator, built-in variables, functions, if-then statements, and custom functions. The last thing we do is fix plotting, since plotting can be very different in HaasScript. So let's copy the code and paste it in a new script in Haas. While converting, I like to keep the tab with the original script open nearby. It will come in handy later. Starting with comments, select double stroke, right-click, change all occurrences, and type double dash. Note that while you're in change all occurrences mode, you are not limited to one word. You can keep deleting or replacing things around the cursor. You can simply delete the study or strategy function. It has no use in Haas. HaasScript indexing starts at 1, while PineScript starts at 0. To change the indexing, Ctrl+F close in square bracket and right click change all occurrences and type +1 close in square bracket. In many scripts, especially older ones, there are no variables type declaration. If there were, we would delete the types because HaasScript does not require type declaration when assigning variables. A single operator we need to check for is not equal operator. In Pine, it is exclamation mark equals sign, but in HaasScript it is tilde equals sign. In this script, we do not have it. Next, we change the built-in variables. They are in red color in Pine. Usually those are prices or dates. In this script, we see that it is close. Let's assign that above. As we type close, we can see a suggestion and we see that in HaasScript is called close prices. Do not forget the parentheses, even if you don't give any parameters. Next, we move on to the meat of the script, the functions and the calculations. Functions are shown in blue in Pine. I find it nice to look through the Pine code line by line to quickly find the functions. The name of the functions are often the same in both languages, so you can just start retyping the word and you will see the IntelliSense suggestions. Most of the time, you'll simply need to capitalize the first letters of the word, or in case of abbreviations like RSI, MACD, EMA, etc., you will capitalize each letter. After changing the name, make sure that our parameters inside the parentheses are listed in proper order. If I hover over a function, I can see the order of the parameters and suggestions for each one. The parameters can be required or optional. The optional parameters are shown inside the square brackets in the IntelliSense. Two things to keep in mind about parameters in HaasScript. One, the required parameters do not have their parameter name before them. Two, you can use the names for the optional parameters, but then the optional parameters should be enclosed in curly brackets. As we convert all functions, hover over them and make sure that the function does exactly what you need. Sometimes there are functions which are very similar in name, but have some important differences with PineScript. Next, we fix the if-then statements and custom functions. There's a single if-then statement here of the IFF type. In an IFF statement in Pine, there are three parts in parentheses. First part is the condition to test. Second part is the value that the variable will be assigned if the condition is true. And third part is what the variable will be assigned if the condition is false. In HaasScript, there is a similarly structured if-then one-liner. It looks like this. Variable equals to condition and value if true or value if false. So to convert, we simply delete the word if and the parentheses, then replace the first comma with the word and, then replace the second comma with the word or. For visual clarity, we can also put this in parentheses. This is useful when we have a multi-layered if statement. Lastly, let's change the plotting. A couple of things to know about plotting in HaasScript. First, you are not limited to one or two graphs per script. As opposed to Pine, in Haas it is very easy to plot different indicators or multiple graphs inside the same script. You simply assign the graph number as the first parameter in the plot. Graph 0 is the main graph with prices. So you would use that for things like moving averages, B-bands, support and resistance, and so on. The graph one is below the prices and is the one where you plot things like MACD, RSI, etc. Positive number graphs are added below the price graph and negative number graphs are added above the price graph. Graph minus one is reserved for trade signals. The graph number is a required parameter of the plot function. There are some more differences in plotting between HaasScript and PineScript. Most of them you can figure out by using the IntelliSense suggestions and some trial and error. I'll probably make a video focused on plotting specifically later. Let's save the script and see if it runs. It's plotting everything, but clearly something is wrong. So there must be a problem in the calculations. As I go back and review everything, there is one function which I am not certain about, that I don't usually use. So most likely that's where the problem is. This max function. You can use log to check what's happening inside there. It gives reasonable values, however, the issue is that EMA function needs a series, not a single number. As we see in the description of max, when comparing an array with a number, the result will be a number. In PineScript, it works differently. So our EMA can't compute. To fix that, we must make an array of zeros, so our max function output will be an array too. Where possible, avoid using for and while loops, as they slow down the execution time. That solves our issue. It looks like the script is working as it should. The script is short and simple, and I used it to demonstrate the overall process without losing focus on the details. So in the next video, I'll show you how to convert some must-know functions and some common things you may encounter in PineScript that may not be as obvious. So make sure to watch that second part. The link will be in the description. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments.